Hello learners, welcome to NIUS Senior Secondary Biology Program, myself Neha Madan. Today we will discuss about the topic Nutrition and Health in much detail. Before moving on to the actual contents of the topic, let us see the major concepts which we have to cover in this topic. There are three major concepts in which this chapter has been divided. The first concept is food, nutrition and disease. In the subtopic of a food, we have to cover the following headings, that is, meaning of the food, its classification on the basis of the nutrients present in it, and the functional classification, that is, the biological functions which food performs in our body. Food. Whenever anyone asks us what are the basic needs of our life without which life is not possible, we often say roti, kapra and makan, that is food, clothing and shelter. Now the question arises, why the food is a basic necessity of a life? There are three questions which comes in the mind, what powers the food have? Why we can't live without food? What does the food contain? In order to find out the answer to the following questions, let us see further. Food. Food is a basic necessity of a life. It can be defined as any nutritive material of a plant or animal origin which when taken into the human body will meet the requirement for growth, repair, development and maintenance. Food is what nourishes the body, it removes our hunger, it gives us the satisfaction and it renews our strength. Food is any substance which performs the following functions in our body. The first very basic function is that it provides us energy for the life processes which take place in our body. Food also helps us in building up the new cells which are required for the maintenance of the body. It also repairs the tissues which get damaged during the life processes. It also aids in the production of useful body compounds. So, I hope you are seeing how much useful food is in our life. Classification of a food. Food has been divided into the two basic categories on the basis of the nutrients present in the food and on the basis of biological processes, biological functions which it performs in our body. Nutrients. Friends, whenever you purchase any food item from the market and if we look at the packet of the food item, at back side of that packet, the detail of the nutrients present in the food are given. Such as, this food item contains this much amount of energy, this food item contains this much amount of carbohydrate, proteins, minerals, vitamins, etc. So what all are these? These are the nutrients which are found in the food that keeps our body functioning. Nutrients are divided into the two major categories, that is macronutrients and micronutrients. Macronutrients, as the name suggests, these are the nutrients which are required in a large amount, large quantity in our body. And micronutrients, as the name suggests, these are the nutrients which are required in a small quantities in our body. Nutrients can be defined as any chemical components of the food which when taken performs the functions related to the body growth, its ability to work, grow, develop and maintain good health. Nutrients are basically carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, water and roughage is also important nutrient in our diet. There are basically 7 essential nutrients which are found in any food item. Number one is carbohydrates, proteins and fat. As we can see on the slide, that these are the major, that is the macronutrients. Vitamins, minerals, they form the category of micronutrients and then there is a roughage. Now we come to the biological classification of the food, that is the classification of the food on the basis of functions which it performs in our body. In this, the food is divided into the 3 categories. That is energy-providing foods, body-building foods, and protective or regulatory foods. Energy-giving foods. These include carbohydrates and fat, And as the name suggests, their basic purpose is to provide the energy to the body on the biological oxidation. Examples are cereals, sugars, fat, jaggery, groundnut, coconut, etc. The second category of a food is the bodybuilding foods. Bodybuilding foods, these are rich in the protein and their function is in the formation of new tissues. As we have discussed, that cells get damaged, so for the formation of the new tissues, we need proteins in our diet. Examples, legumes, milk, egg, meat, pulses, nuts and oil seeds. Another category of the food is protective or regulatory foods. This include vitamins, minerals, water and roughage. The basic purpose of this category of the food is to protect our body from the different infections and regulates the internal metabolism in the body. Examples are fruit, green leafy vegetables, amla, watermelon, orange and citrus fruits. Let us see the three food groups in this table. The first table tells us about the energy providing food, and the major nutrients of energy providing foods are carbohydrates and fats. And what are the food sources from which we can get this energy providing foods? These are cereals, rice, wheat, maize, sugar, fats, oils, ghee and jaggery. These all are the energy providing foods in our diet. Another category of the food group is bodybuilding foods. And the major nutrients of this bodybuilding foods are proteins. And from where we can get the proteins in our diet? We can get the protein from the milk, legumes, egg white, meat, chicken, mutton, fish. The next category of the food group is protective food. The protective food, the major nutrients from which we get the protective food are minerals and vitamins. And food sources are green leafy vegetables, roughage such as fruits, beans, amla, guava and all the fruits and vegetables. Now, till this slide, we have covered what is food and what are the classification of the food. Now, move on to the next sub-concept, that is nutrition. Learners, what is nutrition? Nutrition is directly related to food intake and changes which it undergoes. Whenever we take the food, it undergoes numbers of the chemical reactions and result into the certain products and processes which comes under the science of nutrition. Nutrition is both a science and a process. Let us see how nutrition is a science in itself. Nutrition is a science that studies the chemical reactions which are involved when the food is taken inside the body, a number of the reactions which take place when food goes inside the body, depending upon the type of the food which we have taken, depending upon our age factor and depending upon our health condition, whether we are suffering from any disease or not. Nutrition is a process. As we can see, the nutrition is a process because it involves the multiple steps such as ingestion of the food, digestion of the food, absorption of the food, utilization of the food for the well-being of the living organism. So learners, nutrition is both a science and a process and it involves multiple processes through which the food undergoes. Nutrition. So what we can say in the simple terms, nutrition is a process by which living organism utilizes the food for its maintenance of life, for growth, for the normal function of every organ and the tissue. But for the nutrition, what we need, from where the nutrition will come to us? Nutrition depends on the nutrients present in the food. So let us see what are the major nutrients which are present in our food. Number one nutrient is carbohydrates. These are the compounds which are made up of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. They release the energy on biological oxidation with the help of cellular enzymes. 1 gram of a carbohydrate gives 18 kilocalories of energy on complete biological oxidation. Do you know that carbohydrate in diet provide us 60 to 80% source of our energy? They are the major source of energy in our diet. Carbohydrates have been divided into two major categories, that is sugars and starches. Sugars are further divided as monosaccharides and disaccharides. Starches are divided as soluble varieties and insoluble varieties. Monosaccharides include glucose and fructose. Disaccharides include sucrose, maltose and lactose. In the starches, we have soluble variety, that is a starch, dextrin and cremol, and insoluble variety, which includes cellulose, hemicellulose. Now, let us start with the sugars. In the sugar, we have, you can see in this table, we have the two categories, that is monosaccharides and disaccharides. Monosaccharides are made up of a single carbohydrate chain. And the two types of the monosaccharides are the glucose and fructose. Glucose is the simplest sugar which can be found in honey, molasses and the fruits like grapes. Fructose, it is often known as a fruit sugar. It is found in the ripe fruits and the honey. On the other hand, we have the disaccharides. As the name suggests, it is made up of the two carbohydrate chains. The number one disaccharide is sucrose, which is made up of one molecule of glucose and one molecule of fructose. And it is found in sugar canes and sugar beet. Another category of a disaccharide is maltose. It is made up of two units of glucose and it is found in sprouted cereals. Another category of a disaccharide is lactose, which is composed of glucose plus galactose. And lactose is often known as a milk sugar. Milk is a main source of a lactose sugar. Now let us move on to the carbohydrate type, that is the starches. Starches, there are two categories, starch and cellulose. Starch is a form of the carbohydrate, which is a storage form of the carbohydrate. We found the starch in the food items like cereals, rice, potato, etc. And cellulose is a fibrous substance which is not digested by the body, but it serves as a roughage which helps us in the bowel movements and it helps us in the excretion process. It is often found in the cell walls of fruits, vegetables and cereals. Now let us discuss a few facts related to carbohydrate. During digestion, carbohydrates, basically starch and sugars, are being absorbed as glucose. Excess glucose is being converted into glycogen and which is being stored in the liver for the subsequent use. A normal person needs 400 to 500 grams of a carbohydrate in his diet daily. What are the functions of a carbohydrate? Why we need carbohydrates in our diet? Glucose is the only source of energy to our central nervous system, that is CNS. Excess carbohydrates are being converted into the glycogen and which serve as a reserve of energy in our body. Lactose sugar promote growth of intestinal bacteria that facilitate absorption of calcium in our body. Cellulose provide fecal bulk and helps in the bowel movement. Now move to the second category of nutrients, that is the fats. Fats are the members of lipids. They are also made up of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Here learner, point is to be noted that fats contain more carbon and hydrogen and less oxygen. They are the richest source of energy in our diet. They are not soluble in water, but they are soluble in solvents like acetone and benzene. Chemically, fats are triglycerides. It is to be noted that 1 gram of a fat on complete biological oxidation gives us 9 kilocalories of energy. There are two major sources of fat in our diet. We can get the fat from the animal sources and from the plant sources. In animal sources, we have ghee, butter, fish, oil, meat, egg, etc. From the plant sources, we have the vegetable oils from the seeds of the mustard, sunflower, safflower, etc. Coming to the functions of the fat. As we have discussed, the fats are the richest source of energy. They form the structural components of cytoplasm and cell membrane. They help us in the absorption of vitamins, that is A, D, E, K in our diet. They act as a precursor of various hormones and they can be stored for the subsequent use by the body. Subcutaneous fat, they act as an insulator to our body. They protect our body from cold, weather and pressure. Fats also provide the padding to our vital organs and protect our vital organs from different kind of shocks. They provide us, they help us in the synthesis of vitamin D and steroid hormones in our body. Now till here we have seen the major role of the two nutrients, that is carbohydrate and fats. Let us now move to the proteins. Proteins are extremely large molecules of amino acids. They are complex organic compounds which are rich in carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and sometimes phosphorus and sulfur, etc. Why we need proteins in our diet? They are needed for growth and development, for repair and maintenance, for synthesis of antibodies, enzymes and hormones. They also be sometimes they can also be used as a source of energy for our body. 1 gram of a protein give us 4 kilocalories of energy. The basic building block of which proteins are made, they are made up of amino acids. There are only 22 different amino acids which are found in the proteins of the living organisms. These amino acids have been divided into 2 categories, that is essential amino acids and non-essential amino acids. Essential amino acids are the amino acids which cannot be synthesized in the body and they have to be provided through the diet. On the other hand, we have non-essential amino acids which can be synthesized in the body and from the carbohydrates, and they need not to be supplied in by the diet. Example of essential amino acid is leucine and non-essential amino acid is alanine. Digestion of the protein. Protein is not easily or simply absorbed into our tissues. It undergoes certain processes. So, digestion of the protein takes place when they are completely converted into amino acids. Sources of protein. There are basically 2 sources of proteins in our diet. We can get the protein from animal sources and the plant sources. Animal sources include milk, meat, egg, poultry, etc. And the plant sources can be whole cereal grains, pulses, legumes, nuts, etc. Protein, the structural component of a body. Keratin, it is found in hairs and nails. Collagen, it is being found in the connective tissues. Actin and myosin, they are present in the muscles. Now let us look at the functions of a protein. The major function of the protein is in building and maintenance of body tissues. They are found in all enzymes like trypsin, pepsin and renin. They also function as the hormones and regulate the body functioning, as such as insulin is in a protein which regulates the blood glucose level in our body. They also act as antibodies and protect our body from various infections. Transfer proteins perform the work of carrying the important substances from the blood to the tissues in the body. Now another category of the nutrient is vitamins. Vitamins, though they are required in a small quantity in our body, but they play the important role in protecting our body from the different kinds of infections and the disease. These are the chemical substances which are required by the body in a small amount. They do not provide us energy, but they act as a biocatalyst. They are essential for keeping our health in the good condition. They are also required for the utilization of other nutrients from our diet. Thank you, learners.